Are you confused and frustrated about iOS application lifecycles? Well, today we are going to dive deep into that. So make sure to hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode, and let's dive into it. So let's demystify application lifecycles. Don't worry, this will be a quite easy to understand tutorial, even if you are a little bit scared of what I'm going to learn today. All of this will be presented in Swift UI, but everything applies to UIKit project too. Just a small details, but I will get into that when we get there. So I have created a demo Swift UI project here, and all I have done here is added a secondary view, just the default Swift UI view, and modified a little bit the content view, added a navigation view, which has a navigation bar title. Inside the navigation view, have a VStack with a navigation link that its destination is secondary view, and it has text for its label. And I added a little padding so we don't get all of that button all the way up. Well, it's not a button, it's a navigation link. So what we are going to learn today is going to start in the project's info plist file. Now, if you kind of know what the Xcode projects were prior to iOS 13, you kind of see that there's a new thing here, and it's called scene delegate. Now, there is an appdelegate and a scene delegate, and I will explain in just a moment why there are two separate delegates right now. What you have to take a look at in the infoplist file is just go into this application scene manifest, and let me just move this a little bit to the left here. And there is this scene configuration and application scene role, item zero. And as you can see, there is a configuration name and the default class name. And the default class name is the product module name, that's okay. And there is this scene delegate, and the configuration name is default configuration. Now, at this point, it's all mumbo jumbo, I know. But what is actually this scene that we are talking about here? Well, prior to iOS 13, we had the appdelegate, which had the application did finish launching with options. It had that view will appear, view did appear, application did move to foreground, did move to background. So all of these were in the application delegate, like in the appdelegate file. And it was in the appdelegate class. But now if you just take a look at it, you only see the application did finish launching with options and UI scene session lifecycles. And that is for configuration for connecting with the connecting scene session, a long function name here, and a did discard scene session. Now, what are these scenes? I ask again. Well, basically think of a new application in iOS 13 as a window, and that is going to be covered in the appdelegate. And there could be multiple scenes. Now, currently, of course, in the default and most cases, there will be only one scene, but there could be multiple scenes. Think of an iPad app which has multiple scenes side by side running in the same application. Now, that is what this scene delegate takes care of. It could be one scene, the first scene delegate and then the second scene delegate. That's a pretty trivial version of how we could use multiple scenes. But for now, take a look at the configuration for connecting scene session with options function. Now, here we return a UI scene configuration with the name and default configuration. Please recall that we have set that up, or rather the Xcode template set that up in the info plist file. And the connection session role, just select this one, so leave that as is. Now, in the comments, you see that it is called when a new scene session is being created. Likewise, the application did discard scene session. Again, this is pretty self-explanatory. Called when the user discards a scene session. This doesn't mean that it's putting the application to background or closing the application. This is called when the user discards a scene session. Maybe you want to do some logic there when one or the other scene or another scene is discarded. Okay, so that takes care of the scenes. Now let's take a look at, well, the appdelegate, Now let's take a look at the scene delegate, because if you recall in the app delegate, there was something called application did enter background, application did enter foreground. And if you're kind of working with push notifications or something like that, you really want to see this in your application delegate. Now it's moved into the scene delegate, because each and every scene will need to see if the basically the scene moved into foreground or background. So let's take a look at the scene delegate. And again, this is these are basically the functions scene will connect to the session, and this is where we add our content view. You are most probably familiar with this function. This is where we initially the root view controller with the content view and so on, and we add it to the window and make key and visible. Now there are some more here, like scene did disconnect or scene did become active, and you will use this most probably more often than not. Scene did become active, scene will resign active, and scene will enter foreground, and scene did enter background. And go ahead and take a look at the comments. It's pretty self-explanatory, but now you need to be aware that all of these have been moved into the scene delegate. Now, that's it for kind of these Swift files. It starts in the app delegate, then moves down to the scene delegate. Now, let's move on to the view, our content view. Now, as you can see here, we have our navigation view. And if you are coming from a UIKit perspective, you already know that your view controllers have something called Viewdidload or view will appear, or and all of these, or view did disappear. Now, where is that in Swift UI? Well, it's pretty self-explanatory. Let's add this onto the navigation view, like on appear. Now, as you can see, we have something with perform. We could just hit a return there and another return to have this closure. And this on appear modifier can be added onto any view. That's the beauty of it. Now, we are going to add this on the navigation view because, yeah, we kind of want to simulate the view controllers on a view did appear function. Okay, so on appear, I'm just going to print out here on appear. Let's just copy this out and paste that in there. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is just build and run, and you will see that we will have this on appear printed out on the console. How awesome is that? Now, what I want to show you is that there is another kind of a counter modifier. It's on disappear. Now, when we show a new view here, like show secondary view, and if I tap on it, you see that it slides right on top of the content view. Basically, the content view does not disappear, but the secondary view will disappear once I tap on this back app lifecycle navigation bar. And that is what we are going to check out. Let's just go to our secondary view, and on the text, I'm just going to add on disappear, and let's just print out here. Oh, not here. Let's just back that up, okay? And now let's just select the code and printing it out on disappear. And this will be pretty straightforward. You already know what's going to happen. We are going to be printed out when I back out on disappear. There we go. And now you have kind of control of the lifecycle. You can do some logic or whatever you would do normally in a UIKit project too. So that's that for our application lifecycle. Now you know kind of 95% of what you kind of need to know in these modern iOS 13 apps about application lifecycle. So now we have demystified iOS application lifecycles. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that notification bell and maybe like it if you enjoyed it. Because in my next video, I will be talking about navigation bar titles that are custom. So while you wait for that, also check out these videos as well too. I talk a lot about iOS development, Swift UI in general, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.